JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 9th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It underperformed the most versus CAD, NOK, the Aussie and the Kiwi in that order, while it lost the least ground against the Euro, the Japanese Yen and the Swiss Franc. The strengthening of the risk-linked and oil-related currencies, combined with the weakness in the safe havens, suggests that the financial community traded in a risk-on manner for another day. Indeed, looking at the equity sphere, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green. That said, investors' risk appetite softened somewhat during the Asian morning today. Japan's Nikkei 225 and Hong Kong's Hang Seng slid 0.21 and 0.25% respectively, while South Korea's KOSPI stayed closed. China's Shanghai Composite surged 1.70%, but this was mainly a catch-up after a week-long holiday. Once again, the driver behind the advance in equities and other risk-linked assets was hopes over more US stimulus, with investors ignoring the fact that COVID infections hit a new daily record yesterday. In an interview with Fox News, US President Trump said that talks with Congress over further COVID relief have restarted and that there was a good chance for a deal to be reached. These comments come 2 days after the president called off negotiations on a comprehensive fiscal package, and the day after he urged Congress to pass partial standalone bills. Yesterday's remarks added to hopes over more fiscal stimulus in the US, allowing market participants to increase their risk exposure. However, our view remains the same as yesterday and the day before. Yes, equities could continue to gain for a while more, but we are reluctant to call for a long-lasting boost. We prefer to stick to our day-by-day approach. Coronavirus cases hit a new record yesterday, and the US election day is getting closer. Risks that add to the uncertainty over the stock market's future performance. Now back to the currencies. The oil-linked Canadian dollar and the Norwegian krone were the main gainers, aided by strong gains in oil prices. Both Brent and WTI rose 3.22% and 3.10% yesterday, propelled by a strike in Norway that raised the prospect of supply cuts, as well as by the potential impact on US production of Hurricane Delta, which is expected to strike the Gulf Coast today. As for today, apart from developments surrounding the strike in Norway and the hurricane, CAD traders are likely to pay close attention to Canada's employment report for September as well. The unemployment rate is forecast to have declined to 9.8% from 10.2%, while the net change in employment is expected to show that the economy added 153,300 jobs, less than August's 245,800, but still much more than the pre-COVID monthly numbers. At its prior gathering, the Bank of Canada kept interest rates unchanged at 0.25%, repeating that they will stay there until the 2% inflation target is sustainably achieved. They also reiterated the view that they will continue with their quantitative easing program until the economic recovery is well underway, and that they stand ready to adjust their programs if market conditions change. They said that both the global and Canadian economies are evolving broadly in line with their scenario outlined in July, but added that the bounce back in activity in the third quarter looks to be faster than anticipated in July. With all that in mind, and also taking into account that the core and common CPIs for August accelerated somewhat, a decent employment report may allow Bank of Canada policymakers to continue sitting comfortably on the sidelines for a while more. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European session, we already got the UK's monthly GDP for August, alongside the industrial and manufacturing production rates and the trade balance for the same month. GDP slowed to 2.1% month over month from 6.6% in July, while both the industrial and manufacturing production year over year rates increased, but less than the forecasts suggested. The nation's trade deficit widened somewhat. Now, having said all that, though, the British pound did not react on these releases. We believe that the currency stays mostly linked to politics and especially developments surrounding the Brexit landscape. Last Thursday, the pound tumbled following headlines that the EU and the UK failed to close their differences gap in the latest round of trade talks, and that the EU began legal proceedings over the UK's plan to override key elements of the withdrawal agreement. However, the currency rebounded on Friday after German Chancellor Angela Merkel said that she remains optimistic that a deal in the EU-UK post-Brexit relationship is still possible before year-end. What's more, EU Chief Brexit Negotiator Michel Barnier suggested that talks could continue up until the end of the month, even though the two sides have set a mid-October deadline for reaching common ground. Thus, GBP traders are likely to focus more on whether there will be more talks and whether we will see some progress in the next few weeks. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.